Absolutely. I must have you been joining us for the debate on the night.
Well, we're going to do a bunch in the fall on television, so I think we'll, the people will be able to see us and hear us.
I'll look forward to those. I just know we're in within 100 days of the election now, and I know that the students really kind of put a lot of work into organizing this. And you know, a month ago, I know they said they were happy to work with your schedule, however, whatever would work for you. So I think they're, you know, I think we're all, a lot of us are disappointed you won't be joining us.
Well, we won't make it this week, but they'll be on.
All right. Sure.
Give the kids a voice.
Thank you.
Works for
good to see you.
Angus, will you do a Second Amendment?
Will I do a Second Amendment? I'm sure it'll come up in the debates we're going to do on television. Everybody
can debate for the year.
Are you absolutely sure enough? If the moderator doesn't bring it up, I think Eric will bring it.
Yeah. Sarah King, thank you for being a good sport. I appreciate it.
Yes,
welcome to Auburn. Good to see you.
In wide wonder at the joy they had found. The head nurse spoke up, said, "Leave this one alone." She could tell right away that I was bad to the bone, bad to the bone, bad to the bone, bad, bad, bad to the bone. Thousand hearts before I met you. I'll break a thousand more, baby, before I am through. I wanna be yours, pretty baby, yours and yours alone. I'm here to tell you, honey, that I'm bad to the bone, bad to the bone, bad. Oh,
Despite King's assessment of the situation, the House Committee on Oversight and Government Reform, led by Darrell Issa, released a report bashing the Department of Energy and singling out Record Hill as a loan that shouldn't have happened. 2 days before the report was released, King dropped his association with Record Hill, dumping all of his stock. He told a Maine news outlet the timing was an amazing coincidence. Actually, Record Hill was notified that they'd be mentioned, and King almost certainly wanted to avoid blowback. Gardner admitted that he'd received a letter of notification from the committee 2 days before King sold his stock. But wait, there's more. From August 2011 to January 2012, the federal financing bank signed checks worth $101.5 million to Record Hill. In March 2011, King and Gardner said they'd expect another $70 million in stimulus funds. As of July 2012, they'd received another $33.7 million in Section 1603 cash grants. A grant, not a loan. Was the grant designed to help Record Hill cover loan repayments that the company couldn't pay? Or was it just double dipping by a highly connected company? If it's the former, this is fraud. For the federal government to guarantee a loan, know the loan is going bad, and then give a grant to a company to pay off that loan is cooking the books.
So if appearing before the American Congress against the president's wishes is enough to put the country in the doghouse, what does Iran get for literally calling for our destruction? You see, the Ayatollah, the supreme leader of Iran, well, he said death to America this past weekend. I mean, listen for yourself.
توجه بفرمایید. البته بله، مرگ بر آمریکا، چون آمریکا اون عامل اصلی این فشارهاست. خودشون هم اصرار دارن بر اینکه متمرکز بشوند روی اقتصاد ملت عزیز ما. هدفشون چیست؟ هدف این است که مردم را در مقابل دستگاه قرار بدن.
That he didn't only like say death to America. Did you see all the people in that crowd? He led them in a chant of death to America. So like if there was any question about whether or not he said death to America, oh yeah, he did. And it wasn't like the Ayatollah said death to America. Ha ha ha, just kidding. LOL. They didn't do that. No, he was like, death to America, die. Now, when asked about it, the White House said, oh my gosh, they defended it. The White House defended that. You know, we're Americans, we are all part of America. So when the supreme leader of Iran says death to America, he's saying death to you. He's saying death to me. He's saying death to everyone. Now, Josh Earnest through the White House through Josh Earnest, they said that this, oh my gosh, I'm directly quoting them. He said that it was, quote, intended for a domestic political audience. That's a pretty damn big audience. Did you see that on television? Can you, like, comprehend this? They're saying that it was just political posturing, nothing to be concerned about. You know, I kind of think that if the supreme leader of Iran is saying, die, I'm going to kind of take his word for it.
This is simply a framework for how Congress will react and process the agreement once it's finalized in June. So I see it as not necessarily upsetting the negotiations. I believe that we can do this. But however, I think it has to be done responsibly. And you opened this by talking about how this has turned into a partisan issue. And I have a real problem with that. And I've told Bob Corker, I'm with you on this, but And if it looks like this is just going to be used as a partisan issue, some way to embarrass the president, to deny him a foreign policy achievement, I'm out, man, because this is too important. This deal is one of the most important agreements of our lifetimes, and I think we're close. I want to see the details. I want to let them negotiate further, see what it actually looks like when it's finalized in June. But I don't think it's a bad thing to have Congress weigh in once the deal is done.
Thank you. Thank you for coming. Except for those malcontents over there. We're here to tell the world that we, the American people, reject the cowardice and surrender by our government to the genocidal terror regime in Iran. We are here to tell the world that we, the American people, are more resolute than ever. We are more resolute than ever to destroy those who threaten to wage war against us, our society, and our ally Israel. This enemy makes a grave error in confusing the appeasement of a president and a Democrat Party and the capitulation of a Republican Congress with the strength and fortitude of the American people. Never before has a president of the United States, never before has a political party consented to funding and arming the enemy. Never before has a president entered into agreements with a terrorist regime that holds Americans hostages, that has killed and maimed thousands of American soldiers, and that seeks nuclear weapons and ICBMs to attack his own country. Barack Obama makes Neville Chamberlain look like George S. Patton. This phony deal allows the Iranian terrorist regime to inspect its own nuclear sites, to continue uranium enrichment, to build advanced centrifuges, to perfect their ICBMs, to spend $150 billion on terrorism, and in the end, to secure nuclear warheads. And as one Democrat after another, one conga line of Democrat after another, supports this surrender, it's clear that the Democrats no longer represent the party of Harry Truman and John F. Kennedy. It's now the Democrat Party of Bill Ayers, Saul Alinsky, and Barack Obama. And the Democrat Party will have blood on its hands as a result of this deal for the rest of time. And let me be clear, this deal sows the seeds of war. The enemy is emboldened, and the enemy will be well armed and seek regional and world domination. How do we know? They told us so. Well, what are the Republicans? The Republicans control that building behind us right now. You see that scaffolding up there? They should take some of that and use it on their damn spines. The Republican Party, particularly the leadership, has abandoned the Constitution and the treaty power of the United States Senate. It is recklessly and deliberately avoiding any serious confrontation with a disastrous imperial president. They can stop this. they can invoke the treaty clause right now. They can suspend the filibuster rule and vote against lifting sanctions right now. They can stand between Obama and the Iranian terrorist regime and protect our nation and our allies, but they won't. Gone is the party of Dwight David Eisenhower. Gone is the party of Ronald Reagan. Instead, we get the party of McConnell and Corker and Boehner. Tell the Republicans, this is not about getting along with Obama, it's about stopping Obama. It's about Americans' interests. It's about our children and the future generation. And a final word. Let me warn the 7th century throwbacks who like to chant death to America in their home country. We Americans have been threatened better by better than you. We Americans have been threatened by forces far stronger than you. And we've obliterated every damn one of them. The American people do not stir quickly. USA.
USA. USA. USA.
And so they can hear us. In Tehran, the American people do not stir quickly. But when we do stir, you will regret it. Tell the Republicans in Congress it's time to step up, enforce the Constitution, and stop this fraudulent deal. And God bless you and God bless America.
I can tell you, seeing Maine by motorcycle is a great way to go because the phone never rings.
Don't you wait up all alone if your phone don't-